I've spent well over a decade refining on what I believe is the most effective and efficient way of training. Unfortunately, we're not all born with great genetics and the ability to add slabs and slabs of muscle. So for hard gainers or ectomorphs like myself, I believe my style of training is by far the most effective and efficient. And that's exactly why I call it high efficiency training. Because for ectomorphs, you can't really spend too much time in the gym. The expended calories and the time on the body of recovery, you need to get it in, hit it hard, and get out. So I'm going to show you this demonstrating, this little video that will show you the style and how I train. If you have any questions, please email me at musclebase79@yahoo.com. Thank you. Again, the overload principles. Basically, on biceps, I believe that the barbell is still superior to every other type of bar, including the cambered bar. Basically, the idea is keeping the elbows tucked in and having a nice wide arc, keeping the weight out in front of you. A little bit of cheating, of course, is there. If you don't cheat a little bit, and consider cheating, you'll never grow. So, here we go. I only do a few exercises for my shoulders. One would be what you consider the Arnold press, where you keep your palms facing you and you rotate as you go up. I do side lateral raises, and I also with dumbbells, and I also do rears dumbbell. But I also do this machine when I have the opportunity to work at that gym. Seated rows, amazing exercise. Here I'm demonstrating a full range of motion. I believe that getting a little extra stretch will significantly help the lower part of your lats. I often see people, they stay perfectly upright like this. One is you can't overload the muscle very well, and two, you're not getting that extreme amount of range of motion. I believe that range of motion is one of the most important aspects when you're overloading your muscle. By far, I do believe that doing dumbbells, I had the most amount of results from. The style I do, I like to bring these dumbbells as far as I can get parallel to my body and then twisting them up as I go. I find getting that extra stretch really, really helps significantly. So that's my go-to number one for chest. Yeah. stiff-legged deadlifts. It is by far my go-to for hamstring development. If there was only a few exercises for legs, it would be this and squats. I love them. It definitely put on the most amount of mass, and it takes a little while to learn the form and get used to it, but once you do, those hamstrings will grow like crazy.
Come on, baby.
For quadricep development, I rely on only a few exercises. Here I'm demonstrating hack squats. I believe that doing hack squats at the end of your routine just really hammers them good and just make sure that you get a full range of motion.